just see if I have you here. There you are. Hi, my name is Calliope, and I'm going to be performing your examination today. How you doing? I see. Let me just write that down. Well, I hope by the time you leave this examination, you feel even just the littlest bit better. Now, it looks like we are doing a general examination. Is that correct? Wonderful. And the name that I have here, is that your preferred name? How do you like to be addressed? Excellent. So, we've got that all squared away. Now, for this examination, I am going to need to be touching you. Is that okay with you? Do I have your permission to do that? Wonderful. So let's start by taking your temperature. Just like you to hold still for me, if you don't mind. We're just going to do a little swipe here. Let me get a bit of a better hold. There we go. Just stay still. Thing, these cotton balls. Perfect. Now, this might take just a little bit. Good. Just along the forehead. What was that? You've had your temperature done on your forehead before, haven't you? Not quite like this. Well, see what the cotton does here. Is that if there is a lot of sweat, then we know most likely you have a fever. Quite warm out. It's not too bad in the office today. Here, let's take a look. Just have a little look. So, I do not see anything on the cotton ball. Let me just come in. No sweat. So, it is most likely that you do not have a fever. Hmm. like to test your blood pressure, if you don't mind. Do you have any preference as to which side we use? No. I can always do both as well. So, if you could give me one of your arms. Good. And I am just going to put this in the crook of your elbow to start. Take a deep breath in. And out. Deep breath in. And out. Listening for a change in the blood pressure. If the heart slows down, then generally speaking, the blood pressure may lessen a little. I'm going to come down the arm a little bit. I'm listening for how the blood rushes, and if there is an abnormality. Let's see. And let me just check the other side. Good. Take a deep breath in. Use the bell. The bell's good for those lower frequency sounds. Take a listen. I see. Well, I think I am pretty pleased with that blood pressure. Now, let's look at your face a little bit more. Your face here. And I have a special tool for this. I have a little rotary tool. And it looks kind of sharp. It is, but with a gentle hand, it is actually quite a pleasant sensation. And I'm just going to be very gentle, running this along the face. Just ask you to sit very, very still. Sit still. Good. I'm just tell me about the different sensations. Is that different than right here? Mm-hmm. And if I were to use it right here, is that different than right here? Mm-hmm. Does that feel different than right here? Mm-hmm. And does right there feel different than right here? Okay. And I'm actually just going to do a little bit very carefully down the neck as well. We can actually do that test on the hands as well. You don't mind if I could see your hands? Good. We can just the wheel over each of the fingers. Each of those feel equal. All of those feel equal. First finger, second ring, pinky. Those all felt equal. Good. Take a look at your eyes. Have you had any problems with your eyes as of late? is a very special tool. Take a look at your eyes today. So, this is an optical flipper. Allows me to get a bit of a different little easier for my eyes. Just have to get the right spacing. Much better. So what I'm doing here is I'm looking at the eyes and then flipping the lenses. Get a good look. If there's anything going on with your eyes, if I don't spot anything, I can flip it and look for any other abnormalities. Look at your eyes. Good. And flip. There. Flip. Sometimes I can see things much better if they are far away rather than very close up. Good. Good. Now, I am going to give these to you. There, and just let me know when to flip. What do you notice about your vision if I flip the lenses? Very good. I think that is quite enough. Your eyes are in good health. Stool right here. little bit of a bonus. We are going to use these to look at your ears. So first, I'd like to start with the hammer here. Just want you to let me know if you can hear this. Hear that? What about this? Can you hear that? Good. So hearing looks good. Now I'd like you to tell me if you can feel, firstly, this cold little metal tip on the ears. Just let me know when you feel it. Just let me know when you feel this little brush. Looks like your ears are in good health. We'll take a look at the heart. I have two different tools we'll use to examine your heart today. This is a 512 hertz. This is a 128 hertz. Most likely, you will be able to hear the 512 hertz fork much better, but it's not so much that it's the sound that we're listening for. I'm more looking for the vibration. That was the aortic valve. Pulmonary. Hmm. husband. Then we can use our 128 Hz fork. Tricuspid of yours is a little tricky. Okay. The heart sounds pretty healthy. So we'll move on to the lungs. I'm going to do something kind of similar. I'm going to listen to the sounds that your lungs make when I just very gently tap on them. So, I'm just going to have you hold still. This won't hurt. Looks like it does, but there is a very light force here. This one, I'm going to use more of an overhand approach, get a little more control. Sound pretty similar. I think that heart and lungs look great. Now for the abdomen, our little applicator stick here, and I am going to be palpating, maybe tapping on the abdomen a little bit, right? So if I could just have you breathe normally and relax as best as you can. Pain or discomfort? Okay. Bit of a deeper palpation. What's this? Is this all right? I'm gonna do some tapping here. Hollow areas are, where the organs are. You can hear different sounds depending on where we're at. Okay, everything in the abdominal cavity. Sounds good. Let's see. And let me see. Now we're going to take a look at your lymph nodes. I'm just going to measure the glands, see if they are enlarged at all. Should be enough, I think. So we're going to start behind you. Behind you at the occipital. And go behind the ears. And while I'm here, I'm just going to go in front of the ears. Submandibular and submental nodes. Yeah, we'll get under here. It's gonna be a little up close for a minute. These ones can be a little tricky. Along the sternocleidomastoid, we have a few different kinds of lymph nodes here. and then lastly supraclavicular above the clavicle. Last thing that I wish to examine is your reflexes. So I'm just going to use this tool. That's about perfect right there. I'm going to watch your reflexes. We have a little light to lead us here. So first we have the Achilles tendon reflex. I'm just going to hold your foot here a little bit, give it a little bit of slack. Wake it up a little. The other side, take your foot just and we can do the patellar reflex here. Reflexes are a little underwhelming. That's all right. Let me look at the biceps reflex. So my hand's just going to hold the elbow. I'm going to lift your arm. I want you to let me take the weight of it here, and I'm going to just stimulate the triceps reflex here. Want to check the jaw jerk reflex. So I'm just going to have you very gently let your mouth hang open a little, just like that. And I'm going to put my finger right in the crease of your chin. That's one of the reflexes where the normal reflex is to not have a reflex. Wonderful. Reflexes are intact. So, I think that'll do it for today. Did you happen to have any questions about any of the tests or your results? All right, wonderful. Just just speechless.
Yeah. It was a great exam. He had excellent results. I'm gonna sign off here. And I think that'll be it.
I'd like to thank you so much for coming into my office for your examination. I didn't find anything out of the ordinary, and I declare you a very healthy individual. And I hope that that continues. But if it doesn't, you can always come back and I can do another comprehensive examination.
Description box where I offer early access to videos, exclusive content.